My mother always taught me to not give unsolicited advice nor try to help anyone unless they ask you for it. I always thought that maybe she was just cold. As I get older, I've started to realize that she was right. Society always emphasizes on the need to help people. I do it too. They tell you that you should help people unconditionally and when they least expect it. None of that is, of course, wrong. Random acts of kindness can change a person's life in many instances. However, there is a flip side to every coin, and it is essential to not mask the other half of the impact of any such gesture. Not everything is bad, same as not everything is good. There is the good in bad, and there is the bad in good. It is not necessarily the worst idea to help people, but it's also neither a great one. And here are three graces where I personally stop helping people and recommend that you should too. Stop helping people who don't deserve your help. It is not always an easy thing to do. We were taught helping people is the right thing to do. You need to unlearn this popular belief. As you grow older, you will discover that you have two hands, one for helping yourself and the other for helping others. Quite a lot of times, people would invite me out for coffee to just pick my brain. They don't understand that I have a family, deadlines to meet. They don't realize that in order to make time for coffee, I would have to compensate for that lost time and stay up until 2 in the morning just to work. If they don't think my time is worth any value, then I don't have time for them. If people don't care about you, you shouldn't help them. They don't deserve your help. Never offer anything for free. Next time if someone asks you something for free, don't agree before you negotiate for the best deal. People will always try to exploit you if you allow them to. If you don't have the time to help everyone, only help people who deserve your help. Remember, the first person you need to help is yourself. If helping people makes you unhappy, don't do it. Simple. Sometimes you have to be selfish and put yourself before anyone else. Ignore what society is urging you to do. Stop helping people who don't appreciate your help. My biggest weakness is that I like to help people. I help people regardless of the fact that they asked for it or not, but you never know when that sort of philosophy could hurt you. The easiest way to turn your friend into an enemy is offering them advice they don't want to hear. When I offer someone my help, I actually want to help. But a lot of the time, people are not ready to accept my help. It is normal. Everything takes time to change and most people don't want it. You shouldn't offer advice when people are not prepared to entertain it, or they could one day come back and blame you when it doesn't work out for them. Stop helping people who don't want your help. Less drama, more time for yourself. Stop helping people if you can't put 100% into it. This is the most crucial one. Offering people help when you're not ready to help is a big no-no. I've done this so many times, and until today I still regret doing it. Helping people when you don't have the skills or time will do more harm than good. It's like being blind and teaching someone else how to paint. You make people miss the opportunities to find better help. Your kindness can hurt people too in some instances. One of the easiest ways to destroy a relationship is by offering help that you can't deliver. At the end of the day, everything can be good or bad. We all need to strive to find the right balance between the two. Always think it through carefully before you offer help to someone else. If you don't, it has the potential to cost you your time, your money, your energy, and the relations you hold dear to yourself, both personal or professional. Everything in moderation, but helping is an exception, right? This isn't true, and too much can be bad both for you and the person you care about. It's time to admit helping others can be a toxic addiction. It comes down to the why. Why are you helping people? There are right reasons and wrong reasons. You can think of 1,000 reasons to justify it, but do you struggle to admit the reasons not to? This means we use our energy up and see relations decay without knowing why. I hated the feeling of not being useful. I tried too hard to always be there to save the day and then was stung when it didn't matter. When you have a strong moral compass, ignoring a chance to do something chews away at your mind. It's an incredibly hard addiction to break because it affects the way you see yourself. You need to save your own strength. Have you ever felt like you're running from one catastrophe to another? Is your need to help others masking toxic insecurity about being weak? I struggled to tell people I couldn't be there because I was mentally unable. It felt like making excuses for my inability to handle the stress. This is the wrong perspective. We only have so much energy we can give others before we are depleted ourselves. We lash out at the people we care about when we are exhausted. In a strange paradox, we end up resenting the people who we want to help. This isn't healthy, and you have to seize back control when you feel this happening. They will understand if they care about you too. It's a yellow flag when someone keeps pushing you when you've told them you need space. When you're under pressure from different directions, try to look at the bigger picture. Where should you spend your limited energy? A modified version of the Eisenhower decision matrix can be useful to manage requests from others. Urgent and important could be your friend has lost a loved one and needs you there now. These situations always come first. Important but not urgent could be your friend is unhappy in their job and wants your help to find a new direction. These are prime options for explaining to a friend you currently have too much on but will be there when you have time. Urgent but not important could be your friend wants advice on what to wear for their date tonight. When you're dealing with important tasks, you may need to turn these tasks down to free up your mind. The urgency of this unimportant task can suck energy from you. And finally, not urgent and not important could be your friend wants you to teach them how to play a video game better. Productivity gurus will tell you to drop these tasks, but they can be vital. These tasks can energize you precisely because there is no pressure. It's not just about energy, it's about integrity. When aiding someone means you have to lie or cheat for them, then you almost feel the weight on your chest. Helping others is supposed to be about raising them higher, not pulling yourself down. It is okay to push back when someone tries to force you in this kind of situation. Stop supporting someone when it means you are no longer taking care of yourself. This is unsustainable and everyone ends up losing. Despite the best intentions, sometimes we aren't as helpful as we would like to be. Most of us are just muddling our way through life and we don't have all the answers. Acting like we can solve all problems for the people we love can do more harm than good. Be honest with yourself about whether you know what you're doing. It's okay to admit your advice has limits. We weren't taught everything at school, and sometimes it's too much for us. It's a tough conversation to tell someone they need serious help. Stigmas around this are easing, but still exists. For some, it's easier to laugh off their issues than to confess how deep they are. Coming to you for aid might have been a big step, so be firm but caring. You don't want someone to be dependent on you when you have no idea what you're doing, especially when you can't commit enough time to even try your best. You let them down eventually. If you really care, you'll know it's more important the person gets better than you being the one who does it. An unhealthy attachment can stop them from looking for support in the right places. At the end of it all, the only person who can change someone's feelings is the person themselves. You can't reprogram their brain. You rushing every time something goes wrong can prevent them from building the resilience they need. They may not take responsibility for the way they feel. Instead of trying to fix things, you should just listen. Sometimes, just listening is enough. It's easy to fall into the savior complex of needing to fix everything. We get the happiness trifecta where dopamine, serotonin, and oxytocin are all released and uplift our minds. Yet, relying on helping for this high can be dangerous, as we always need someone to have a problem for us to fix. I have done it many times myself. I remember being on a call with a friend who was venting about problems at work. Sometimes saying things out loud makes things click in our brains. Don't undervalue the power of listening. Compassion is not a relationship between the healer and the wounded. It's a relationship between equals. Does the person need you to do anything? While you think you are helping by offering magical solutions, it may feel more like they are being patronized. Compassion only works when you see the other person as an equal. Make sure your influence is always empowering. It's not always about what you would do in their situation. Follow the rule of treating people how they would like to be treated. It's not about what you want. We can get angry at people for not listening to our advice when we aren't listening to their problems. Listening is rewarding when you share mutual love and respect. Yet, it's still important to value your time. There's a thin line between boosting others by listening and being used by some. This truth may hurt, but not everybody cares about you. We all have a world inside our heads and can forget others do too. For them, you may be a minor character who is sometimes useful. It doesn't make them evil, as we are all guilty of this behavior at times. Yet, When someone doesn't care about you, then you must protect yourself from a one-way relationship. You're giving up parts of your life that could be better spent on yourself or others who do care. An obvious sign you're in this type of relationship is when the person will ask you first before even attempting to solve the problem themselves. You are not Google or Wikipedia, so stop acting like it. I am much more likely to help someone who tells me what they have tried first. When we help people who treat us in this way, we increase their sense of entitlement. Nobody can make demands of your free time other than you. You don't need to be a martyr for those who don't care. If your blood starts to boil at seeing someone's name or face, it's a sure sign dropping them could be the right thing. Those who care will talk to you even when they don't need anything. The people who find you for no other reason than they missed you or wanted to see how you were doing. Simply, they treat you like a human. I like to help people who help others. They may do nothing for me, but their attitude shines brightly even from a distance. There are many worthy people in this world to boost, so don't lose time on those who aren't. Not helping someone does not make you a bad person. Say it out loud. We can fix everything in the world. A random act of kindness can change someone's life, but it can also destroy one too. If you help the wrong people, you can miss the opportunities to help the right people. Think before you help. If you enjoyed this video, I'm sure you will enjoy my other video essays. Thank you for watching. Like this video if you liked it. My name is Ai, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.